Hello, and welcome back to Kaiserredux, New York City Attacks Us Edition. Also, I think the Mexicans are about to square off with us, which is, like, probably bad for them. So we're about to go to war with everyone. On the same side as the syndicalist, which is, like, you know, that's something. Okay, I mean, that's fine. Yes, sir. Hey, listen, if the Germans don't want to square off against us, we're so cool about that. So cool about that. We're gonna refrain from signing any agreements. We're just gonna attack with like everything we've got. Apparently that's not enough. Well, that's too bad. No, I'm not signing non-aggression packs with you. I am now, okay, we can give you a doctrine. I'm gonna do division recovery organization, I guess. We're just gonna conquer the Mexicans real quick. I mean, they attacked us. Okay. The Sentinel of Freedom! Okay, this is funny. For a long time, America remained staunchly isolationist when it came to the world, especially European affairs, leaving Germans, Russians, and British and French to the destructive Great War and contending themselves guarding the Americas from foreign invasions and incursions. This recently changed, however. We found ourselves at war with the most prominent nation in the old continent, the German Empire. Many of our citizens and political elites are suspicious or even hostile to the idea of sending our boys off to war in such a distant theater, but not everyone is. Among them, comic book artists Joe Simon and Jack Kirby, convinced of the righteousness of our war against the Germans, recently created the character of Captain America, a young American named Steve Rogers, fragile but convinced of the righteousness of the war, who received a serum transforming him to a super soldier with strength, agility, stamina, and intelligence, the peak of human potential. Armed with a shield and uniform bearing the American colors and accompanied by his faithful sidekick Bucky, the captain embarks on a crusade with our troops to defeat the German enemies. The first episode in this comic book series, recognizable by its cover featuring the captain decking the Kaiser, was a huge success, with sales topping the million mark, inspiring our brave troops and greatly encouraging recruitment. Give him hell, Cap! No, we're not aligning with you. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. Merge. Sail over here. Oh yeah, we were gonna, we have extra planes? Yeah, we have some. Yeah, not much. We got some transports. Let us shove these nerds into a theater. Wise men in the White House. Wait, we have resistance? We do not. We have economic aftermath. Military industrial complex. We get rebuilding America stuff. Great. Let's do that. Who dares wins? Anti-tank gun. Howitzer. Toad. Oh yeah, we're just sort of like casually annihilating the Mexicans. Right, okay, so everything is core now. Great. There's a brief moment of, like, confusion when that wasn't the case. I'll just do that. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Yeah, because we just got 18 of those. So. Let's raid some convoys. Alright, finally, results in Finland.
just gonna do that, and then, do that. Who dares wins. Gonna go insane. Nope, that's not it. Nope. Okay, cool. Great. I don't know. Sure. All right, fine. I finally figured it out. Okay. Ace pilot promoted yet again. I could stand to exhort some more heroism. Yeah, that 90, minus
97% is pretty crazy.
Those are casualties. Not good. This is the nature of, like, a lot of infantry attacks. Ally with the common man. I think some populism, if there's an argument for this, is listen, we got here because of a failure of the elites to do populist things, right? Like, everyone wanted to vote for Long because no one ever got anything that they wanted. So we're gonna ally with the common man. Really, that's super interesting to get no tank designer.
Keep on moving.
Just gonna bump that up. The supply situation here is not ideal. Rip Argentina.
Under fire. Come on, move out. Taking cover. Fall in. I'm moving.
I like how Eisenhower is still a general somehow. Like, he's the president. He can't really be a general, let alone a general under someone else. Oh, cool! We shot down a New York City pilot. He thought he was hot stuff, but he's never tangled with us. I'm just gonna decommission all these templates that like I'm not using. I'm glad the decommission button exists. See if this does anything, like.
Pushing them back, sir.
Why not research? Yeah, I'll just research it. Yeah, later. Time to get a better light tank. Because these are very bad now. Cast armor. Yeah, gas engine's fine. Nope. Want a three-man turret. We want that improved cannon. Advanced radio. Armor skirts.
I saw the little table that stood in our breakfast nook.
It could be better, but
mother, where you first learned how to cook, they looked so out of place without your pretty face.
I mean, sure.
I found our little arm.
I'm gonna have to transition to, like, good tanks soon, but, like, for now, that's probably fine.
Keep on moving.
Tied with labor. Expand the military.
Second
Alright, I'm just gonna leave that. So here's my plan. Because these, I'm gonna try landing there. Just gonna halt, go home. Oh, the Germans are here. Yeah, I'll just dump the whole thing in, whatever. More ace piloting! What the heck is Albert Kesselring doing here? Smiling Albert! Say it ain't so. We want the better light tank chassis, obviously. It's risky to invade here, but I really want that flanking bonus. So that when, and additionally, when units get like, okay. Okay, union laws. During the Civil War, most unions chose to rebel against government, with the lion's share going to the combined syndicates of America. Unions are a thorn in the side of the business union, the business community, and now that there is good reason to punish these unions, they are insisting we do so. Most of our advisors believe that punishing the most extreme unions, those who joined the command syndicates would be enough to send a message to loyal unions, keep them in mind for the future. However, a group of influential men, led by Curtis LeMay, are pushing for us to ban all unions, essentially killing the labor movement, currently causing a backlash in the process. What should we do? Punish syndicalist unions? Or just ban all unions? We're going to punish syndicalist unions. Sorry, you're allowed to be a union, but you're not allowed to be a traitor. With the Civil War now over, our enemies at our mercy, the army has begun trials against the Union's generals. While some generals are threatened to exile, the generals who were caught are now waiting for the verdict of the military tribunal. However, despite what the public believes, it's not as easy to carry out the trials as was individually anticipated. Most trial generals don't have any record of unnecessary violence, and even those who do can claim they were following orders during the trial. Eisenhower sent the government a list of high-ranking individuals who he thinks are worthy and capable of rehabilitation, with ample evidence exonerating mainly General Danvers as a case of due obedience. Despite requests and evidence he provided, there's no denying that in America's darkest hour, they and many others who followed them ended up on the wrong side of history out of their own volition. While some of the captured generals were sworn to quit, even if forgiven, there are other men who pledged to defend America The America we saved, if they are forgiven, but the final decision rests with the jury. Spare them, discharge them, exile's the only thing they deserve. We are going to spare them. Punish the wealthy. We shot down a Polish pilot. Hey! Interesting. So the reason we're landing here is so that these forces here can't retreat. There's no supply here, which makes this incredibly risky. But the trial of the Federalist generals. Literally the same thing. Most trial generals. Most controversial one is Dwight Eisenhower. You mean the president? Okay. That's so funny. Okay, well, that's extremely buggy. We're gonna spare them. That's something. I was like, there's gonna be some bugginess because this is Kaiserredux, and this is sort of an obscure faction. It's very funny that, like, the current president is like, should we spare the president? Is he a traitor? It's like, I mean, he's the president. We elected him. We chose him as the president because he was, anyways. Cool. I'm just gonna knock this down the bottom. That doesn't need to be here. Yeah. So now we're just gonna... Republic of South Africa's joined the Reichspakt and has also joined the war on our side. It's been a very expensive attack that I have not paid any attention to. Okay, I probably should. You should go here, you should go here, you should go here. Sudan has lost the war, predictably. Okay, they've broken our ciphers. Yeah, we should probably get around to... We should probably get around to creating an intelligence agency. That would be intelligent. Supply grace would be nice. Right, that's why. Alright, sweet. We have... fly these guys over here. In other words, darling, kiss me. Approaching the wealthy! When the Civil War broke out, America's richest families were divided in their loyalties. Some fled to New England, largely avoiding the war. Others fled to the Pacific States, seeing the rightful continuation of American government. There was no shortage of wealthy families that stayed loyal to the federal government, seeing us as both the legitimate and moderate option amongst the radical factions. Regardless, now that the country is reunited, there were calls to punish the wealthy in some way. Whether they were loyal or not, the argument goes, they all profited off the deaths of their fellow countrymen. As such, we should decide how much we want to deal with them. We could impose harsh taxation on unpatriotic wealthy families who sided with their enemies. When this would be popular with our people, we'd hope to take a harsher approach and impose higher taxes on the entirety of the wealthy elite. Whether they were loyal or not. This would give us more than enough funds for reconstruction programs, but also have negative impacts on our economy. What should we do? Punish unpatriotic wealth, or punish the wealthy? We are going to punish unpatriotic wealth. And with that, we will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.